Well then, this is an exciting time. As I said, the reviews have been leading up to this point right now. This, in my eyes, is where Disney exploded. They exploded into a world of possibilities. The animation improved, the stories improved, the characters improved, the settings improved, the actual animation of like the movement of the camera, the what happens on the screen. It's the first time we saw like 3D effects. And this is of course the Walt Disney Animation Classic number 30. Beauty and the Beast. Where to even start with this? Set in France. I'm sure it's set in France, isn't it? Set in France. Beauty and the Beast is a little village, and there's a girl called Belle. She loves to read books. Everybody knows each other in the village. Her dad is an inventor.
Yeah, she just loves to read books. That's basically
the thing about Belle. She loves to read books. Then there is Gaston, who also lives in the town. The big hunk man, the big hunky guy. He lusts for Belle, and he makes no secret of it. He believes he can get any girl that he wants, which up to that point he can, obviously, because he does. I've met Gaston, made fun of my ponytail because I had it up in a bun and he believed it should be flowing free. So basically he just shut me down completely. He's a very intimidating man, Gaston is. He's very intimidating. So Belle doesn't like Gaston, so this causes a problem because he wants to marry Belle. Gaston wants to marry Belle. And by a turn of events, by a crazy turn of events, Belle's father ends up in this castle. He ends up prisoner in this castle. A castle that people believe to be like empty, and they'd only heard rumours about this castle. And Belle jumps on a horse, goes to the castle on her own to get her father. And there she finds that the castle is not at all, is not empty. It is inhabited by a beast. And basically, Belle exchanges her father's imprisonment for her imprisonment, so her father goes free and she has to stay at the castle. The film now takes an unexpected turn. Everything in the castle, from the pots and the teacups and the candles and the clocks, are alive and they can talk, and they all have a very forward idea that they want this girl to marry the beast, basically. Battery's gonna run out. I'm gonna finish this on the laptop. Anyway, we're back here. Yeah. They want the beast to, they want her to marry the beast. I think this is where it was. The beast has lived there on his own for like as long as the clocks and everything have been there, and he has lost the will to look for somebody to marry. He's very angry, he's very rude, he's very aggressive, and he doesn't know how to talk to somebody who he wants to be married to. It all turns out there has been a spell put on the people of the castle by a witch who was turned away in the rain and the thunder, when she needed a place to stay. She was turned away by the beast when he wasn't a beast, and everybody in the castle was human, and because of his unhelpfulness and rudeness, she cast a spell on them all and turned them into objects and turned the man into a beast until until he could find true love and marry a girl. This was all kind of like looked over by a little rose floating under a glass dome. The rose is shining, the rose is floating and spinning. And when the rose dies, they are all beasts and objects forever. So they all want the beast to marry Belle. Gaston hears of this. Back at the village, remember Gaston? Gathers all the men to fight. And they want to go rescue Belle from a castle. Over time, she don't want to be rescued. She likes being there. Gaston is being aggressive because he wants to marry Belle. And
the pig. This is so silly
yawning. So they all rush off to get Belle. And they get to the castle and it starts raining, of course. And they attack the castle while looking for the beast. There's a big fight. This is where the most heartbreaking thing I've ever seen happens. Something very unexpected. It's a spoiler alert also. And Gaston kills the beast. Stabs him up, and he's dead. Nobody can believe it. It's just unreal, isn't it? He kills the beast. The guy's name is in the title of the film, and he dies. After that, the film does continue. I'm not going to tell you what happens for the rest of that film. But it's extremely good. It is the songs in Beauty and the Beast, such as Beauty and the Beast. The song about Gaston. Is it called Gaston? What is it called? Don't know. It's about Gaston, though. They all sing it about him. But anyway, the film Beauty and the Beast, first time I watched it, horrifically, was last year. What does that even mean? It was last year. I was 20 years of age when I watched Beauty and the Beast for the first time, and I call myself a Disney fan. I immediately gave it a 10 out of 10, and I have not changed my ways since. It is a 10 out of 10 film. Everything about it is perfect. Notable characters are Lumiere, the Candlestick, and Cogsworth. The clock, these play a big part in the castle, like for Belle being, like wanting Belle to get married. Beauty and the Beast is about to get a remake, a live action remake. The teaser trailer just came out, it looks incredible. Emma Watson as Belle, Ewan McGregor as Lumiere, Ian McKellen, Sir Ian McKellen as Cogsworth. You fool! This is going to be a fantastic remake film. I hope you're prepared for it. I want another trailer very soon. I'm excited. The film Beauty and the Beast, thinking about it, it just gets you emotional. It gets me emotional because it reminds me of It reminds me of going to Disney World, probably more than any other Disney classic film. I've come across another one on the way through these reviews, I'll mention it, but Beauty and the Beast. We met Gaston, we met Belle. So much of Magic Kingdom is themed around Beauty and the Beast, with like Gaston's Tavern and Be Our Guest restaurant with the big with the Gaston's castle up on the hill in Magic Kingdom. Don't know why I'm looking up there, like it's there. It's in Magic Kingdom. And it makes me sad that I'm not there. I'm here, I'm not there. Which isn't good. It's very expensive to fly from England to America to then go to all the parks and everything. So it can't happen that often. Matt is going this year. That'll be good. But I am unfortunately not. I will be here. So I'll just watch Beauty and the Beast on end, on repeat, until I go back. Okay. So yeah, it was a 10 out of 10. Definitely a 10 out of 10. My favourite character is Lumiere. And that's it. I like this film review. It felt good to talk about Beauty and the Beast for a little bit. So I hope you enjoy it. I hope you do enjoy this film review. Just, it's not a film review, is it? It's just talking about the film. But it is fantastic. Please, if you have not seen it, by some insane turn of events like me, when you are 20 years old, watch it now, please. Please, please, thank you. But of course, everybody's already seen it. It was me, it was the last person on earth that hadn't seen it yet. So there we go. Beauty and the Beast, 10 out of 10. Tune in tomorrow for Disney's second installment of a beautiful, beautiful film. That'll be number 31. Tune in tomorrow to see where it is if you don't already know. And thank you, thank you, thank you.